Hi there, it's Nick Psaila and welcome to today's episode. Today we're going to be speaking about the four steps to creating killer content. Now, as a business owner, you can create all different types of content. It could be things like, you know, video content. It could be online content like downloads. It could be offline content like magazines, like newsletters, like catalogs. Online as well, it could be newsletters. It could be, you know, vlogs, so it's part video, part blog. It could be things like, even if it's just a little download sound grab. It could be things like, PDF download. It could be, you know, literally anything from audio to video to downloadable PDF. This is all content. So I believe that there's some key elements when you're creating content as a business owner. All right, step one is I believe that you need to research your market and your avatar. It's no use giving content that doesn't appeal to your client avatar. So, you know, if they want to know about gardening, it's no use talking about engineering products or electronic fittings, right? It's the wrong content for the wrong demographic. Now, it's not to say that they don't do that, but if your business sells gardening products, you want to be speaking to them about all different facets of gardening. Now, could you maybe, you know, add, cubby house building to that? Absolutely. Could you maybe add, you know, something around, you know, designing a firefox for your backyard from tree to tree? Could you talk about hammocks? Could you maybe talk about barbecues? Yes, because it all sort of happens in the garden, and all of this is relevant content, usually for that type of client avatar. So it's really important to research your market and look at and see what are people consuming, what type of content are they consuming. So the how-to content is really good. You know, how to grow roses in a, you know, 2 foot by 2 foot square box if you're in an apartment, as an example, right? So that'll be really good content, how-to. You know, how to, you know, plant those tomatoes so you've got beautiful, you know, red juicy tomatoes without having any, you know, bugs or flies, you know, spoil it, right? This is how-to content. It's normally really, really good. And that's just an idea. I mean, it could be, you know, 4 or 5 things you need to know when, as an example, you know, looking for a real estate agent. So this is content, once again. It's a how-to or a user guide around content. Now, step two is, what's really relevant to them? It's no use giving information that they can't use. So having newsletters as an example with, you know, did you know that RBA interest rates have stayed the same, and you send that, you know, 1 week, 2 weeks, you know, 3 days after RBA interest rates have already been announced, well, guess what? That's not relevant content. It's not really relevant to them because they've already heard it on every media channel that you could possibly think about, radio, TV, Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, whatever it may be. So it's too old and it's just not happening, yeah? Now, what's really relevant is current affairs style content. In other words, something that's happened and how maybe your business is tied into maybe into that genre. As an example, so if you're somebody, I don't know, as an example, that's in the security business, and you know, we just had, you know, some really, you know, tough terrorist activities that have been happening, you know, around the world. Maybe you can talk about, you know, the 3 steps that you need to know, around securing you and your family and maybe your premises, right? So do you see, it's very relevant, it's very now, it's a current affair that's happening. This is unbelievable, excellent levels of content that you're able to do because it's very relevant and people like to know, you know, how it affects them and what they can do, especially in that scenario, yeah? Number three is, how can this content be used by them? So once they've been given that content, how can they apply it into their life? So whether it's in the personal development field, you know, here's some brain patterns that you can practice. Here's 3 meditation tapes that you can download to check us out. Here's maybe, brain stimulation exercise that you can play, and this is how you do it. Here's how you can download our app. Any of these type of things, by the way, apps content as well, right? It's an awesome content delivery mechanism as well. So do you see, when you show them how it can be used, the content gets richer and their experience gets richer by engaging with that content and using it, yeah? And the last part is, it needs to be short, punchy, and where to next. It's no use writing, you know, 18 pages, 65 page download, or, you know, here's the 30 page business plan that you can download. It's too long. People just don't get, you know, they lose interest. Why? Because today we've almost got this shiny object syndrome. Oh, look, there goes a squirrel. Oh, look, there's shiny bright lights here and there. So people just want really short punch. You know, here's a three-step thing that you can do. Here's four steps to creating killer content. It's a short video. Do you see? All of these things are very, very important. Short, punchy. How does it help me now? How is it relevant to me? So if I'm somebody that, I don't know, you know, has never painted before, if you say, you know, here's the three brushes that you can use for the corners to get the best level of painting, and, you know, this is where you can get the brushes, here's the download, and by the way, here's the download on how you can get your free drop sheet. Do you see? It's really specific, it's really punchy, and it's fast. And most importantly, what you want to add to is where to next. So in your content, you can write, by the way, if you like this, here's another level of content that's similar to what you just had, but maybe it's, you know, if you like growing tomatoes, let's talk to you about indoor plants as an example. See, it's on the same genre. Or here's four steps that you need to know when choosing a barbecue for your backyard. So I'm hoping you really enjoyed this, and most importantly, practice makes perfect, right? Content doesn't come easily. Now, by the way, what I strongly suggest to any business owner that I work with to outsource creating content, you can just give the, you know, people that are writing the content or recording it for you the outline of what you want, and then they're able to do it, especially if you're not, you know, killer at making content yourself, right? And they can use this as a guideline. So step one, research your market avatar. Step two, what's really relevant to them. Step three, how can this content be used by them? And most importantly, make it short, punchy, and where to next. Hope you enjoyed this episode. I'm Nick Psaila, and I look forward to seeing you on the upside.